Hello guys, so today we are going to design a tabbed activity with the help of some tab layout, viewpager, viewpager adapter and fragments. Okay, so we will design an application like WhatsApp where we can swipe left or right. Fine, so we will try to add three tabs like chat, status and call. Okay, so let me quickly do what? Add a design part over here. So what we need in a design, first of all, we have a linear layout, that's fine. Now we need to create a tab layout. Okay, so let's create a tab layout. So you will find it over here. So you can give it width as match parent and height as wrap content. So this would be what? This would be holding your tabs. So let's assign it some ID as well. So that's a tab layout. And then we need what? We need a view pager. Fine, so view pager is actually attached on the top of this tab layer where we can swipe left or right with the help of view pager. So this view pager actually is what? It is a layout manager that allows you to flip left or right throughout your pages. So your pages would be what? Your pages would be in the form of fragments. So let's add a view pager. So we have view pager 2 as well. Let's try with the view pager this time. So you can try. So height, you can use your whole height. Fine. So for better, we can give it design as well. Background color. Let's give it some ID. Let's say view pager. View pager. And for better, I can give it a background color as well. Let's give it something, some hash code. And so you can change it from here. I just give it a light red color, and the view pager would be of any color. So you can see here the view pager is holding your whole space, and this tab layout is holding just this part of your screen. So this gonna show you multiple tabs over here, the titles of the tabs, and this gonna hold your fragments to show different pages. Fine. Okay, that's all. So design is complete. And now before moving ahead, we need to create a fragment as well. So on one page we will be displaying one fragment, on second page we will be displaying another segment, and so on. So let's create a new, right click here, new, and I just create a fragment. So I will say blank fragment, and we can name it as what you can give it. Let's say we need to create three fragments. So I will say what? First of all, chat fragment. So we need a Java file as well. Just finish it. Okay, so once you do this, you will be able to see the design part as well as coding part. So what I do is I will remove the extra code over here, the comments and everything. So what we need only one method. That method is what? Create view. Nothing else is required. Okay, so this is actually responsible for inflating your fragment. So let's remove everything and we can move to the design part. So you can also customize it. So what I'm going to do is I will just try to convert it into linear layout, and I will just display the text over here and simply saying what, and simply I will say that chat fragment. Okay, so let's change it to chat fragment, and for better we can give it some size as well. So I will increase the text size to, let's say, 48 sp is fine, and I just want it in the center. So I just make it wrap. So I will reuse this fragment and I will just change the thing. So we need a gravity so that I can align my text into the center. So that's fine. One more thing I will add over here. I will just give it a background color. Okay. So let's give it a background color over here with the help of background. And I just give it some random color. Oops. So hex code. And you can click on this box and change the color whatever you want. let's say this would be my background color for this fragment. Fine. So we have done with the design. Nothing is required to be changed here. That's fine. Now what I will do is I just copy paste this code. Okay. So chat fragment is there. Copy this, paste it, and this one gonna be my status fragment. Okay. So here I will say what? Instead of writing chat, I will say status fragment, and I just change this color as well so that you can differentiate the pages. So that's fine. And same way, I'll just copy this and I will create one more fragment, that would be my call fragment. Again, just go to the design part, change it to call fragment, and change this color as well. Click over here and I'll just take it to some this color. That's fine. So design is ready. Now corresponding Java files are also required so that you can inflate the view. I just copy this, paste it, and this one gonna be my status fragment. Don't forget to change this layout file. So this one would be my status. Save this. I again copy this, paste this, and this one gonna be my call fragment. And don't forget to change this to call. So my fragments are ready to be displayed. Okay, now design is ready, everything is fine. Let's move to the coding here. The first and the foremost thing we need to initialize my view so that I can get the reference over there. So I just use this here IDs. So let's create private tab layout. So tab layout, and the second one is private view pager, that is view pager. And okay, so we need to initialize it. So what I do is I just create here init method init views. This gonna initialize my views with the corresponding IDs from this. So let's create this method and simply say what tab layout is equal to find view by id r dot id dot tab layout, and same way I will do with the view pager. View pager is equal to find view by id r dot id dot view pager. Okay, now these two things are ready. Now what I need to use view pager where I will display the pages. The problem is that we cannot directly display data to the view pager. For that we need to use an adapter. Okay, so let's create another class named adapter class. Right click, new Java class. So I will name it my view pager adapter. Okay, so this class should be extending the view pager adapter. View pager adapter. Do we have any view pager adapter? No. So actually we are working with fragments, so you need to extend fragment pager adapter. Fine. So once you extend this, you need to implement its methods because it is a abstract class. So let's quickly overwrite the methods that we have not implemented yet. Fine. Now still you will be able to see some methods, some errors over here. So here you need to override one constructor as well. So let's create a two constructors are there. You can use any of these. The first one is deprecated, so we will try to use second one. Okay, now errors are resolved. Now what you need to do here is this adapter gonna display your data into the view pager. So this gonna hold some list of fragments to be displayed. Fine. So this get item method gonna return you one fragment. So that means you would have a list of fragments. So we would have three tabs, so that means I will be holding multiple fragments. So I will do what? I will just create an array list. I will create a private array list of what type? Fragment type. Okay. So let's create this fragment Android X, and this I will name it fragments. Fine. And that's fine. Now we also need to display the titles on the tabs. that on which tab you are, whether you are in a chat tab, status tab, or somewhere else. So same way, I will create one more list of titles. So this gonna be of string type. Fine. So in the constructor, I will be initializing this is new array list, and same way I will do with titles as well. Otherwise, you will be getting null pointer exception if you are not doing this. So don't forget that. Okay, so done with the constructor is done. Now this frag, this gonna return you, this guide item gonna return you one fragment. So from where you will be getting fragment? From this. So I will say what fragments dot get. So here you will be getting by default one index, that is position. So we can pass it here. Same way for int get count gonna give you number of fragments. Okay, number of tabs. So how you will get this? Again, you can simply say fragments dot. Do we have any size? Yes, we have a size. Done. So once you call this, internally it would be calling to attach this data with the fragment adapter, pager adapter. So what to do is, we need to display titles as well. For that, we need to override one method. That is, the method name is something title page title. So see, get page title, there is a method. So this should not return super dot get page title. This should return what? Titles dot get and pass it the index, that is position. So your adapter is ready. Fine. Now one more issue is there. So this adapter is fine, it is returning you one fragment, it is counting it, then it is returning title, but where you are passing data to this? So for that, what I can do is I can create one more method that say void add fragment. So where you can pass some fragment. Okay, and once you pass the fragment to this, you need to add that fragment to fragments. Okay, so simply say fragments dot add, that is fragment. Okay, but the problem is that we are not taking any title somewhere. So let's create one more argument over here of string type and simply assign this title to titles as well. Titles dot add. Oops, I'm missing something. Okay, so actually I have given the same name, so I just change it, then you would be better getting this. So title, that's all. So your adapter is complete. Fine. Now you have almost done everything if you have done this. So simply go back to your activity, main activity. So what you have to do here is very simple thing. So first of all, you need to initialize your views. We have already initialized. Now you need to create adapter over here. So how do you create an adapter? So name of the adapter is my view pager adapter. Let's say adapter is equal to new my view pager adapter. But here you need to pass two things. The first one is fragment manager. If you can recall here, first one is your fragment manager. Second one is behavior. So behavior will be letting you know the state and state of your fragment. And if you talk about fragment manager, it will actually interact with the adapter. So how do you get a fragment manager? So simply there is a method get spot fragment manager. So this one will return your current fragment manager, and the behavior you will be getting from, you can get it from your constants. So let's do what fragment pager adapter. So here is one of the behavior that you should use. Okay, resume only current. So this gonna create a adapter. Okay, this gonna create a initialize views and creating adapter. So once your adapter is ready, what you need to do? Set adapter to view pager. Okay, so how do you set it? So simply say view pager dot set adapter. Do we have? Yes, let's pass this adapter. Now your view pager is ready with data. Now this view pager you need to set up with a layout so that it should work properly. So simply say what? Tab layout dot set up. Do we have any view pager? Set up with view pager. Okay, so simply pass your view pager over here. Okay, so you are doing what? Set tab layout with view pager. Okay, that's all. Now you need to add data to adapter. So simply say what? Adapter dot, there is a method add fragment we have created for adding a fragment. So which one you want to add first? Let's add a chat fragment first. So new chat fragment and give it a title as well, chat. Same way you have to set data for other fragments as well. Second one is status and the third one is call, and change this to call fragment and change this to status fragment. That's all. Now once you run this again, you will be able to see everything is working fine. Just wait for a while and almost done. Okay, here you go. So you can see swipe, swipe, go here, go here, go here. So that's all. I hope you like it. You can find the code in description. That's all.